still voting at 1 o'clock in the morning, or having to stand in line for 6 to 8 hours. And, you know, somebody that I was talking to down in Miami, where that was the problem was biggest, sent me a spreadsheet showing every day the lines went longer, more and more people started showing up. And they were going out there saying, you can thank Rick Scott for these lines. So I think it was really a PR problem and maybe even costing some votes. And it's just something needs to be fixed, et cetera.
Yeah, if you look at election reform in Florida, after the 2000 embarrassment to our state, we had major election reforms the next year and the year after that. And it was a very bipartisan approach. The further we got away from the 2000 election, the more in Tallahassee that any attempts at election reform got more and more partisan. And what we saw happening is when Democrats did not get their voice heard on election reform in Tallahassee, they turned to the courts. And they started using the language of voter suppression. And on the other side, the Republicans were equally concerned about fraud. We had people removed from office in Madison County from absentee ballot fraud and so forth. It became a very partisan issue. But now, what's happening is it's an embarrassment. Again, I got a call from friends of mine as far away as Oregon saying, what is wrong with your state? So I guarantee you that we will see bipartisan election reform in Tallahassee this spring. And what is going to be driving it are a lot of the supervisor elections. I feel sorry for them. They're the ones who get the brunt of all of this when much of the problem is caused in Tallahassee. And I'll stop there.